See, Kyle, see, that's a great point. You see, Kyle, you see, you, everybody read what Kyle just said. You see? See, yesterday I said exactly that. What does this have to do with us, right? Everybody's like, because, but Kyle, the answer was, oh, well, basically we're going to get him out of the game if he's a snitch. And I'm like, dog, what this shit got to do with us? You feel me? Unless we about to like sell dope with him or gangbang with him, none of this shit should have nothing to do with us, money. We're here for his bars. We're here for to be entertained. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, so the only reason why I'm reading this is because it's a topic in battle rap. And I like talking about deeper shit than just what's on the surface level. And we're going to really see if he is a so-called snitch, because my definition of a snitch is probably not what everybody else's definition is. Of July 5th, 2009. One regular patron, Mark Doster. There we go. There we go. So that's either, if I'm not mistaken, that's our guy. Oh, that's Slade's brother. Okay. Okay. So we got Slade's brother is the next character. One regular patron, Mark Doster, who lives on Albany in an apartment adjacent to the 24-hour store, was familiar with the people who lived in or frequented the area around Bedford and Albany. So this is Slade's hood, right? It's at least his brother's hood. You feel me? This is where they, you know what I'm saying? They know the niggas around there. You know what I'm saying? It's their hood. That's how I interpreted that. Let me see. Was familiar with people who lived in or frequented the area around Bedford Street and Albany Avenue, including the defendant, who was known on the streets as Ape. What people is telling me is David Doster is Kyd Slade. All right. So the defendant then told Doster, don't worry about it. So, yeah. So anyway, it says, see, Doster testified. OK, so this is he did it in testimony. OK. All right. As these events were transpiring, another regular patron of the 24-hour, Tyrell Mohan, who had met the victim for the first time that evening, entered the store, purchased a cigar that he and the victim could smoke marijuana together. Damn, he just met him the first time so he could smoke? Damn. After making the purchase, however, when Mohan went behind the 24-hour store to meet the victim, he saw the victim surrounded by five men, including Neutron and John Dickerson, named Jerk. Mohan testified that although he did not see the defendant, Esser, in the group, he recalled that at least two of the five men had covered their faces with bandanas. Shortly after he came on the scene, Mohan saw Neutron strike the victim with a baseball bat several times in the upper body. The other men began punching and kicking the victim, who collapsed on the ground. Dog, what is he doing, dude? He's drunk in the bad side of town. He got warned, don't go over there, and he's trying to sell product in somebody else's hood. It's crazy, dog. The other men began punching and kicking the victim, who collapsed on the ground. The victim, still unconscious but unable to walk, stated that he thought he was about to die and asked Mohan to call the ambulance. Mohan returned to the 24-hour store to use the payphone to report. Whoa. I missed something. Mohan testified that he did not see the defendant S in that group. He recalled that at least two of the five men had covered their faces with bandanas. Shortly after he came upon the scene, Mohan saw Neutron strike the victim with a baseball bat. The other men began punching and kicking the victim, who collapsed on the ground. Mohan then saw Jerk take out a gun. I'm sorry, I missed this. And fire one round into the victim's back before the group scattered in different directions. The victim, still conscious but unable to walk, stated that he thought he was about to die and asked Mohan to call an ambulance. Mohan returned to the 24-hour store, used a payphone to report the shooting, not wanting to get involved, did not identify the shooter. So at this point, I'm going to search to see if we find, you know, let's find a name. Let's see. Where is it where you can search for names? Let's see. Let's go up here. Is it find? New tab, new window, Zoom favorites, apps, games, extension. Find on page. So David So it's dateless. So let's put Doster. Okay. Oh, so right here it says. Okay. Right here. I was the paragraph I was on. It was Doster. The state disagrees. Okay, the state disagree, asserting that the jury was given ample circumstantial evidence from which reasonably could have inferred that the defendant solicited, ordered, and intentionally aided Jerk to assault the victim by discharging a firearm. In support of its position, the state relies more particularly upon the following evidence: that the defendant was affiliated with MJB, a gang of drug sellers in the Bedford Street area. That the defendant was an enforcer of the gang's drug selling monopoly. That the defendant had made statements to Doster before the shooting, indicated that he personally was going to talk to the victim. Oh, wow. All right, let's get to another Doster. Let me go up to see if I missed a Doster. Okay. Did we get this one? Yeah, it says Doster testified, as previously noted, a couple of minutes before the incident happened. The defendant approached him and asked if he knew it was associated. When Doster said that he did not know the man. Okay. All right, cool. So let's go to 12. There's 23 times his name was mentioned. Okay. All right. Bandana supported Doster's testimony of someone who believed to be the defendant. Okay. So Doster's testimony. Okay. So once again, we have Doster's testimony. Once again, we have Doster's testimony. I don't see David. You know what I mean? So it's a Mark Doster. I have not seen a David Doster. Here's another one. Doster. But once again, it says, moreover, the defendant contends that there was a substantial lapse of time between the alleged statement to Doster about going to talk and to handle the person. Okay. All right. Additionally, Doster testified that just a few minutes before, when Doster stated that he was not. OK, so it sounded like it was his brother, man. OK, we're at number 17 out of 23. We're at 18. OK, Doster. Yeah, I'm going to do David next. From testimony whom Doster had observed. OK, I just want to be careful, Tim. That afternoon. After the testimony of Campos and Doster, both of whom testified without further objection as to the drug evidence. Okay. 21. In his brief to the court, the defendant maintains that Doster testified that in his conversation with the defendant occurred hours, not minutes, before the shooting occurred. The transcripts demonstrate, however, that Doster expressly stated that his conversation with the defendant occurred maybe a couple of minutes before the incident happened. Although Doster equivocated on this timeline during cross-examination, it is the sole province of the trier of the fact to resolve the discrepancies. Okay, so they're having an issue. It sounds like it's his brother. And that's number 23. So, yeah, here's Doster. So, yeah, let's find David. Let's see. There's no David Doster. Let's search for David. There's one David, and it's David Zagaja. I don't see anything for David Doster. At least here. There it is. We just went over it, right? Oh, let's put Doster's brother. I don't see Doster's brother. Nothing pops up. Let's just put brother. Okay. The defendant's brother. Okay. So we have the defendant's brother. Okay, there's that. And then we have another one that says, what is this? Oh, this is a transcript. This is a transcript. The following colloquially occurred in the prosecutors. Okay, prosecutor, have you heard anything about the incident? Presented anything Easter? How long? So why would his homie share it with Tay Rock? Is it because his brother was a snitch? Or is his name really Mark Doster? How, you know what I'm saying? Is his name because, wait, hold on. So let's see. So at least on this paperwork right here, in the case of James Rayner. Now let's do this. Let's do this one last thing over here. A DNA Tooth. He posted. DNA Tooth posted the actual document that Tay Rock passed out. Okay. And let's see. Let's take a look at it. Yeah, there's the paperwork. Let's go to community. All right, here it is right here. So yeah, it's in James Rayner. It's the case of James Rayner, guys. It's the case of James Rayner. Okay. Let me see. Let me right click. We the right click. Let's see. Okay. So it says State of Connecticut Superior Court. This is James Rayner. Application for arrest warrant. Okay. Oh, this is an application for an arrest warrant. Well done, MV Double. Well done, MV Double. Okay, somebody cleared it up. Somebody cleared it up. All right. All right. Okay. So we know what happened. Okay. So we know what happened in July 5th, 2009. So this is something different. On April 24th, 2013, David Doster. So this is different. This is different. So I guess what I read was something totally different. Oh, you know why? Well, anyway, let's just go over it. So wait, so what are we reading before we, this is an affidavit, State of Connecticut Superior Court. Okay, wait, what is this? This is application for arrest warrant. So it's an affidavit. So this affidavit concerns the assault of Mark Doster. So Mark is it? Mark got what is it? He's a victim by ape by look. The affidavit concerns the assault of Mark Doster by James Ape Rayner. So that same James Rayner nigga, right? The same one. That brother attacked Mark Doster. Probably because Mark Doster snitched on him. Okay? Remember? Mark Doster snitched on him. That's facts, right? Can we all agree to that? We all can agree to that, right? What we just read, we didn't read that in vain. That wasn't for no reason. We read it, right? And it says Mark Doster testified against the case of James Rayner, who's ape. Okay. So guess what? So that's that. Okay. So this is affidavit. The affidavit concerns the assault of Mark Doster. Okay. All right. So let's get to the other, where was this at? Here it is right here. It was probably Mr. Beckett said that his and assistant had a firecracker go off. Beckett indicated the assistant, two men in the car in the area. 40 mile inch jerk called him. Yo, jerk and eight. Them niggas is over here causing problems. They're straight gang members, drug dealers causing problems over there, dog. Beckett was shown somewhere a video that investigators retrieved from YouTube. He confirmed to the court that it was indeed the video he filmed in the backyard of Bedford Street. He pointed out the man in the video identified as James Rayner, a heavyset guy with a beard who was arguing with the younger guy. So there's a video, somebody find that for me, somewhere Bedford, Connecticut. I'm not sure what the rapper's name is. And then put, okay, because that's the video that Tay Rock is talking about. That's the video because they played the YouTube video Beckett was shown the somewhere video that investigators retrieved from YouTube. So they use that as evidence. That's what they're doing. Because anyway, here he goes. Let's read. On April 24th, 2013, David Doster, Kyd Slade, testified before a Superior Court judge. So he testified. David Doster testified inter alia. What does inter alia mean? What does inter alia mean? Inter alia, among other things. Among other things. All right. We got to get it right. We got to get it right. It means among other things. All right. He testified, among other things, that on June 13th, 2009. So remember, because what we're looking, this happened. So this is June 13th, 2009. This was July 25th, 2000. This is July 24th, 2009. This story with Luis, July 24th, 2009. So 749. And this is 6:13:9. So this is before. All right. David Doster testified that on June 13, 2009, he, Mark Doster, Antron Gore, and a friend he only knew as Josh were on Brook Street playing b-ball. Kyd Slade, David Doster, stated that while at the location, a man he knows only as Ape. Wouldn't that be his brother? No? Okay. Approached him and said that they were going to shoot a rap video in the back of Bedford Street and to go over there and get in the video. David Doster stated that he knew that Ape meant him and his friends from Bedford Street. Doster stated that he then went to the location near the rear of 5153 Bedford Street. So that's it? That's snitching? Like, come on, dog. Like, that's snitching. Let me finish reading. Once at that location, David Doster stated that in addition to Ape, he also remembers Platinum, JJ, which is Jerk. Remember Jerk from earlier? Little Decky, identified as the MGB. What was that? Money Green? What was his brother's name? Money Green. Money Green Bedrock. All right. Identifies Money Green Bedrock or an associate of Kevin Leslie and a couple of other subjects referred to as flunkies as being there. David Doster stated that everybody was chilling, laughing, getting ready to shoot the video, getting drunk. David Doster stated that his brother Mark was debating with Platinum about rap. David Doster stated that he guessed that Ape didn't like what Mark Doster was saying because at this time Ape began to hit Mark Doster in the face area with a liquor bottle. David Doster stated that his brother attempted to defend himself against Ape. David Doster stated that he jumped in between Ape and his brother and was trying to break up the fight, that Ape and Mark Doster were punching him over him and Platinum over him and Platinum. David Doster stated that Antron Gore was behind him fighting with an unidentified male. David Doster stated that Gore got hit in the head and his head was busted open. David Doster claimed that he did not see Ape with a handgun and could not comment on to whether he possessed one that day. So he would refrain from giving circumstantial evidence. Maybe that's not the word, or you know what I mean? Like, Sure. Like, what are you going to do, man? He was there. He was there in the rap video. So what you going to do? Say you wasn't there? Like, come on, my nigga. Like, he was there, but he was like, nah, he ain't have no gun. He said it, right? He said, man, he ain't had no gun. David Dosher said that Antron Gore was behind him fighting with an unidentified male. David Dosher stated that Gore got hit in the head and his head was busted open. I don't think, is that what they're going to court for? Just for that? Let me see. David Dosher claimed that he did not see 8 with a handgun and could not comment on whether he possessed one that day. David Dosher confirmed that he accompanied Antron Gore and Mark Dosher along with Josh to the hospital where they were both treated for their head injuries. David Dosher viewed the video somewhere before Superior Court Judge. Dosher identified the people he known as 8, Platinum, Decky, J Jerk, and Starks. David Dosher identified the bottle that was clearly visible on the video in Ape's hand, consistent with the size and shape as the bottle that was used to assault his brother Mark Dosher with. David Dosher said that following the assault, he did not return to Bedford Street area because he was fearful for his personal safety. There you have it. There you have it. Here's his name written one more time, and I'm just going to just read this because I see his name here. On May 16th, 2013, Antron Gore testified before Superior Court Judge, testified inter alia, that on June 13th, 2009, he was chilling with his friend Mark Dosher on Brook Street, where there were when a guy who was riding a bicycle came over and told him they were shooting a video on Bedford Street. Gore said that he, Joshua Hodge, David Dosher, and Mark, so these are the same story from another perspective, went to where the music video was being shot. Gore said that after the video stopped, an argument ensued between the guys who was working the camera for the shoot and one of the rapper's friends about the music in the video. Gore stated that as they were arguing, they went to Rupert's gas station alone, which was 50 yards across the street. So I'm going to be honest with you. Like, this wasn't no gangbanging stuff. This wasn't no dope dealing stuff, right? The man, his brother, if I'm not mistaken, right? His brother got busted in the head, right? His brother got busted in the head with a bottle, right? And all he did was point out that, yes, that's him in a music video. Thank you for the follow, Rod Meister. Slade told the courts who beat up his brother. Yes. Well, not necessarily, right? Not necessarily. He just said that the courts can deduce that. But he just said that person, that is Ape. Yes, that's Ape. That's a Jerk. That's Platinum. That's Starks. That's me. Here's Gore, okay? Gore denied being assaulted on, as both Mark Dosher and David Dosher testify he had been. So Kyd Slade and his brother both testified that nigga Gore got assaulted on. And Gore's like, nigga, I didn't get assaulted on. So he's trying to like not snitch. Instead, he claimed that he was assaulted at Rupert's gas station located in Albany by an unidentified male he knew from jail. You see, that was the evidence right there. See, the evidence from the victim. You see, the evidence from the victim is really what gets you, you know, locked up, right? Gore said that he did not know about Francis Hospital where they were both treated for their injuries. He's lying. So there it is. I mean, that's up for you. It's up for you. We went over. We took the long way. I read something totally different. I'm glad we did, though. It gave us perspective on who's who. It gave us perspective on the neighborhood, where they come from and stuff like that. You know, what do you guys think? You know what I'm saying? Like, how I feel about, you know, snitching. To me, it's like you anyway. Man. Let's hear what Kyd Slade has to say. I don't think this should be the end of his battle rap career. You know? I just don't think so.
The nigga jerk, you pussy. You just did this shit out of pure envy. But what I'm gonna say is this, I'm gonna wrap this up in a minute and I'm gonna try. I got subpoenaed to court out of a jail cell. Anybody that don't know, you can't tell the warden or CO that you're not going to court. They're gonna rush the cell. While I was in the dorm, they're gonna rush the dorm.
See, there goes some evidence right there. You're already on the video, man. And he's saying he was already detained. Saying that's them is too... Damn, this snitching shit is crazy. Let's finish.
Everybody get on their bunks, put the Hannibal mask on you after they drag you to say, put you in a wheelchair, drag your stupid ass in the courtroom, and you're going to court, point blank period. I'm not going through all that just to say I didn't go to court. Only thing you got to do is when you go in court is not roll on niggas. So I went into court, and they literally asked me, do you know such and such, this such and such, put a gun out on you. That's why the paperwork say, Slade said there was no gun there. So that's what I was going to court for. They said, yo, did anybody pull a gun out on you? I'm like, no. Nah. Did such and such do this? I'm like, no. No, I don't even know who that is. Honestly, I don't know who that is. They running these names down. They running names.
Is that, I don't know, that might be cap right there. I think he just threw out a little cap. He said, I don't know who they are, right? Did he just say that? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and he's kind of scratched his neck right there. Because remember, we just read it, my nigga. We just read it. Now, I'm looking for inconsistencies in your story.
Show me putting niggas in jail for that. The nigga jerk, you pussy. They put you in a wheelchair, drag your stupid ass in the courtroom, and you're going to court, point blank period. I'm not going through all that just to say I didn't go to court. Only thing you got to do is when you go in court is not roll on niggas. So I went into court, and they literally asked me, do you know such as... such, this such and such, put a gun out on you. That's why the paperwork say Slade said there was no gun there. So that's what I was going to court for. They said, yo, did anybody pull a gun out on you? I'm like, no. Nah. Did such and such do this? I'm like, no. No, I don't even know who that is. Honestly, I don't know who that is. They running these names down. They running names. Jerk, Deck, Platt. They running niggas' names down from the block. I'm like, oh, I don't know these niggas. So then they play the music video. Oh, you don't know these niggas? So why are you in the video right here? And then they got a slideshow of pictures from funeral. Rest in peace, Zeke. They had pictures from Zeke's funeral with all of us outside. If you don't know these niggas, why are you in all these pictures and in this video with niggas? What, explain this. And I had to tell him, I'm like, yo, I didn't know that by those names you was given. Oh, these my friends. These your friends in this video? Yes, these are all my friends. Nobody in this video would do anybody any harm to me. Nobody tried to do anything to me in that video. These are actually my friends. Y'all got false information. These your friends. These your friends. Well, we're hearing this. I don't give a fuck what you heard. These my niggas, and pretty much that's that.
Yo, I think, well, let me just finish. Let's listen to him first.
They start antagonizing, trying to make me mad and shit. And as far as the hospital shit go, they like, we know you were at the hospital with your brother in Antron. We have the footage. We have the surveillance video of y'all in the hospital. You were on the phone in the lobby, and then they started getting into detail. You were on the phone in the lobby, hostile. You were in the bathroom. You walked into the bathroom on the lobby, on the phone, very hostile. You walked outside and was in the parking lot. They got me on camera at the hospital. There's no denying camera footage. So yeah, I told them, of course I was there, nigga. But I don't know what y'all talking about. Nobody tried to shoot me. Nobody ever tried to shoot me. I'm Slade. And then when they told me, well, if you okay with them, why don't we see you over there no more? And I told them clearly, because there's nothing over there for me but niggas coming through, shooting the block up. I almost lose my life all the fucking time. And every time I'm outside chilling, y'all jumping out, taking me to fucking jail. So there's nothing over there for me. I'm straight. Ain't nothing over there for me. Prison. And then they hit me with the, well, you in prison right now. We know what you're doing out here, and blah, 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 because I went OT to get some real bread. You know, niggas stayed in the hood broke. I went OT, caught that case, and that's why I got subpoenaed to court. So for what it's worth, bro, I ain't never told on nobody. You telling niggas I got 60, I got one nigga 60 years, one nigga 37 years, and one nigga's 10 years, because they bring me in the courtroom, okay, you told them I told the police somebody got hit with a bottle, and that got one person 60, one person 37, and another person 10. What was the, was that a nuclear Heineken bottle? What happened? Y'all niggas gotta make it make sense, bro.
I think it's shout out to Tim 804. I think our brother Tim has been caught in a legal situation before, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct, Tim? If I'm not mistaken, you told me that I don't want to put too much of your information out there. He says you realize that he literally said I had to tell him. That's not what I'm saying. So yeah, if I'm not mistaken, I thought you said, Tim, that you was in a that you were found not guilty and you was facing big time. If that wasn't you, I apologize. But anyway, I do think that. So I feel like it's easy for people to say what they would do and what they wouldn't do when they're not in that position or never been in that position. You know what I'm saying? Like. You can't go to court and lie, my nigga. He said I was found guilty. You can't go to court and actually lie, my nigga. Now you're like you're a witness. You trying to do perjury, nigga? You trying to do perjury and go to jail? Like, come on, man. Like, dog. Like, there's certain things, my nigga. If they got evidence, you know what I'm saying, of a picture with you and your baby mama, you can't say you don't know your baby mama. Like, come on, my nigga, you can't do that, my nigga. Like it's just like a lot of us, we sound tough, like we sound like we street niggas, like, but like a lot of us, we're not street niggas, first of all. You know what I'm saying? And third of all, like, nigga, when you're in that position, then you can judge, man. You know what I'm saying? So my whole thing is like, my nigga, like, you be like, once you get in these situations, it's like, I just feel like it's easy to be on the internet talking about what the next man could have done just for a bum ass reputation and some, you know, you know what I mean? Like, that shit is all like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this whole no snitching shit is this shit. It started with the criminal class. You know what I'm saying? And then through proliferation of hip hop music, it went into regular black men. Like, now regular black men, like, be on this no snitching shit, nigga. That's a criminal ethos. That's a criminal ethos. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a criminal, my nigga. I'm not. I'm a law-abiding citizen, man. I vote. I pay my taxes. You feel me? So at the end of the day, my nigga, like, you know what I'm saying? A nigga commits crime against me or my loved ones, nigga, there's testimony. You know what I'm saying? There's testimony, man. I don't give a fuck. And I don't feel like these things, this shit happened in 2009. Let's say he did make a mistake. Let's say he did something like that. What? So you don't want to hear him battle rap no more? Like, but what if he's good? Like, so what? You know what I'm saying? I don't know, man. Like, and then another thing too is like, oh my God. Everybody snitches, man. Like, no snitching is like trying to be perfect. Like, to me, it's an ideal that people want to reach. You know what I mean? The no snitching is an ideal that is hard to practice in reality. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man. So, anyway, I mean, obviously, he's a criminal, right? He was a drug dealer from MGB. And based on what we read, what do you guys think, man? You think, you know what I'm saying? Do you give him the snitch jacket? Was it an unfortunate situation? Basically, what we read and what he said here, it kind of jives together. It kind of jives together, man. Let me continue.
Real shit. Free my nigga Black. My nigga Black is locked up with eight toll Black, I ain't telling him. Killer was locked up with eight told killer, I ain't telling him. If I told on eight that eight been jailed because of me, y'all niggas, y'all, that's y'all man, right? Get him on the phone and have him say it. Y'all gotta stop doing this, bro. I know y'all don't like me and y'all jealous, but stop painting lies, bro. Ain't nobody.
That would be a good battle. That would be a good. You guys are smart, dog. Yeah, hey, dog, straight up. Kyd Slade versus Adi Boom, nigga. hosted by Tekashi. Hip Hop Israel got the Tay Rock video with dude.
This my man calling me right now, Hartford.
That's not your man.
You ain't got a response to it. Look, I got family here. Hip hop is real. You feel me? We about to sit, relax, and I'm gonna let you talk this shit. You feel me? But let my man's know that you let him know who you is to Kyd Slade for real though.
No, listen, that's my childhood friend for real. Like, I'm gonna keep it a buck with you. That's my childhood friend for real. You feel me? If you can Google this shit, my nigga, you feel me? I'm from Hartford, Connecticut, nigga. Bad rock, nigga.
Shout out to my nigga Jay Jerk, idiot jerk. Look at my nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
So that's Jerk. So yeah, we read about this brother. That's Jerk.
You feel me? That's who I am. Follow me on the gram and all that, you feel me? Real nigga shit, but that nigga know what it is, nigga. I ain't got to lie.
Hey, it's nothing else that you ain't, look, he ain't got to lie. Show him everything with that nigga name on it, nigga.
Look, nigga.
Fuck is we talking about?
Damn.
That nigga, he had mad paperwork, bro. Look at that shit.
My nigga, what? I don't know what that is, bro. I don't know what that is.
Yeah, making this shit up.
My nigga, that's not satisfactory.
Bro, the nigga he ratted on got out 6 years ago. I told you that. All fact. He got home 6 years ago.
Look at this shit, man. Look at this shit. This is real shit. Look at this shit, my nigga. I ain't got to lie. You feel me? Look at this shit. Look, that's my brother name. Mark Dawson, nigga. Look.
That's the shit we read. Yo, if I was Tay Rock, I would need you to read that shit. You know what I mean? That's not satisfactory.
So bro could get it because you were.
That's right. Thank you, Tay Rock. Get the hell out of 7-Eleven, my nigga.
Like, you get what I'm saying? Testify before a superior court judge.
Damn.
Like, cut it out, bro.
So you really vented that?
That was Mark Doster. First of all, Hip Hop Israel, you're doing a terrible job being an investigator, dog. You're supposed to be asking questions, man.
The nigga that was trying to troll me. Really, it was Kyd Slade, childhood friend that he ratted on, nigga. How crazy is that? Come on, now. Like he said, niggas can Google it. Niggas ain't fucking playing, looking at this shit.
Yo, Hip Hop Israel, they have to do a way better job, dude. They have to do, like, come on, what is this? Like, you're not asking him. You have the man on the phone. You're a journalist. You're supposed to ask questions, man. You know what I'm saying? Wow, just because he said it and he's showing paperwork. My nigga, Mark Doster is not David Doster. My nigga, come on, what are we doing? You got it up on your platform, and so you're co-signing it as if, yeah, Hip Hop Israel, you know what I'm saying, blah, 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 Kyd Slade, yeah, look, Tay Rocks, yo, bro, another thing, like, I'm not doing this shit just for views, you understand, like, I'm trying to get to the facts, right, I'm not just salacious, ha, 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 because this is real shit, right, we're talking about brothers really in jail, dog, you feel me, so I'm not over here just, ha, 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 yeah, yeah, Kyd Slade, oh, yeah, he a snitch, man, ha, 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 turn it up, ha, everybody, you know, like, and comment, and subscribe, like, no, I'm actually trying to read and get to the facts of this, you know what I'm saying, look at this shit, Tay Rock FaceTimes Kyd Slade, childhood friend, who allegedly Slade told on to verify the paperwork. My nigga, get to the bottom of this, dog. They not trying to get to the bottom of it. They just trying to get the clicks and the likes and this shit is a game, dog. Justify what? I gotta make sure the claim is real, dog. See, I'm telling you, man, I seen this shit happen with Chris Unbiased. Nigga, Chris Unbiased, dude, there's nothing, like, dude, it's a dead docket case, you know what I'm saying, the girl that they say, like, dog, man, this girl come out and say something like barely anything. Everybody want to jump on the bandwagon. Yo, man, niggas is simple, dog. That's all I'm trying to say. Niggas is simple out in this motherfucker, man. All you got to do is say, yo, man, the sun didn't come. The sun's not coming up tomorrow, man. For real, man. Look, check out this YouTube page. Nigga, the sun not going to come up tomorrow. Everybody, oh, nigga, the sun not going to come up tomorrow. Oh, nigga, did you hear? Nigga, the sun not coming up tomorrow. Oh, nigga, huh? Nigga, the sun not coming up tomorrow. Oh, nigga, retweets. Ah, oh, nigga, sun not coming up tomorrow. Nigga, tomorrow, nigga, the sun come up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas is over here talking about he snitching, my nigga. Like, where, my nigga? Like, dog, I'm the only person I've seen do the due diligence to figure out if he did or did not. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas is going to be like, just take it because the next man said it. Like, I'm sorry. That's just not me, dog. I'm just not going to take it because the next man said it. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to be honest with you. I am giving him the benefit of the doubt. That's what I am doing. I feel like he deserves it. I am. I'm going to be honest with you. I am giving him the sin. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I don't have to do that. Some of y'all are not doing that, but I am. I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I mean. You guys go ahead and call up, man, 424-261-3107 if there's anything you'd like to say. You know what I'm saying? What is snitching? You know what I'm saying? What is snitching in the black, you know, in the black community, in the hip hop community? What, you know, what is, that Tekashi shit, that's snitching, my nigga. That shit snitching. You supposedly he was blood. Yeah, I'm blood, right? Committing crimes, you know what I'm saying? Putting money on people's head. Yo, man, this nigga Tekashi, dog. Nah, Epic, I do not. You know what I'm saying? And then he go to court like, no, I'm not really a gangbanger though. But those men, those are the ones that are gangbanging. They did this and they did that. And like, it's, you know what I mean? Like, you benefited from them brothers, bro. You benefited from them brothers. They were your protection or whatever. And now all of a sudden you just, you know what I mean? It's snitching on all of them. Like, that shit is very cowardly. You feel me? That shit is cowardly. But if somebody's in an uncompromised position and they're asking you, do you know the person on the video? And you say, yeah, maybe to you, that's snitching, man. Like, I don't know. To me, that's not snitching. To me, that's not grounds of like, you're unloyal to your friends, dog. You feel me?